When many companies think about launching, they think about how do I advertise? How do I work with the media? How do I get my name out there in the marketplace? And they start to think of long lists of things that they need and need to invest in. The idea of a reference group or a club or an organization or an association that fits within your target market can often be one of the best places to start for a couple reasons. They're available, they're usually easily identifiable, and oftentimes they're free or low cost. The question becomes, how do I use these organizations or these reference groups to the best of my ability and get the most out of them? Number one is get involved, obviously, right? And get involved requires a physical presence. Maybe you've heard the saying before, you can fake caring, but you can't fake showing up. That kind of applies to reference groups. You need to show up, you need to have a physical presence, and it needs to be over time so people start to get to know you. The reason being is because this will yield conversations and interactions and start to build relationships. Number two is start to get good at painting a vision. So by painting a vision, I mean when you're interacting with people within this association or this group, right? What you're trying to do is everything from test your messaging to understand if they know anybody in your target market that might be a good contact for you, or perhaps they are a target market. This is an opportunity to get many and repeated interactions with these type of people, right? So the better you are at painting a vision about what it is that you do well and how it can help that person or somebody that might they may know, the better off you'll be. Painting a vision can include things like telling the stories about your pertinent background and what about your background and your skills and your experience or the experience of your small and growing company is unique out in the marketplace. Painting a vision can also include explaining, perhaps through stories, how you've been able to help your target clients in ways that are of high value and even share some client testimonials. So this concept of painting a vision ends up being a lot more memorable than just bullet pointing, here's the three things we sell and we offer, right? Painting a vision helps them to create a picture in their mind of what it is that you do so that they can walk away from that group and to retell your story. Or that on the spot, they can say, hey, you know, I know somebody that might be interested in what you do. Number three is something that many people overlook in these groups. I call it include and ask being, you know, the verb, right? So include an ask in there. Ask them, after you've painted the vision for your background and what you've done for your clients and told a poignant story, include an ask. Do you know anybody that might benefit from this? Or do you know anybody in my specific target market that I might like to talk to? Until you actually put forth that ask, it's really easy and natural for people to marvel at your story, perhaps, but then move on to the next conversation. Including that ask will kind of force them to pause for a moment and say, do I know anybody? And you'd be surprised at the reaction. And number four, the final one, and perhaps the most important, is give first before you're asking and before you're getting. Think about these organizations as a way that I can go to these meetings, meet these people, and truly and genuinely look for opportunities to help them. I found in my personal experience, and I counsel certainly my individual clients, that the more that they find themselves out giving in their reference organizations or in the marketplace or even in their communities, they'll be amazed at how much comes back to them in the form of an introduction or a referral.